Hey there, MacBook users. Want to share Recoverit, a cutting-edge and trusted data recovery tool, can help you to get back your lost and deleted files within seconds. If you're a MacBook user who's frustrated with your device constantly restarting, don't worry because you're not alone. Many MacBook owners have reported this exact same issue, and that's why we've come here with some effective solutions to fix the restarting Mac issue. Before going deeper into this topic, don't forget to hit that subscribe button down below with notifications turned on so you never miss out on our future videos. Okay, let's get started. Let's first start with the basics and figure out exactly what causes the restarting problem on your MacBook or MacBook Pro. Although there are many reasons why your MacBook or MacBook Pro might keep restarting, installing an unreliable third-party app can be one of the main reasons, as this causes something called kernel panic, which causes your device to restart. If your MacBook identifies any fatal internal error on boot up and the OS can't process normally to recover, then an error message will show up and your MacBook will reboot. Apart from that, incompatible hardware, insufficient RAM, and outdated drivers can also lead to restarting problems in your MacBook. So let's dive into the solutions to fix your restarting MacBook problem. Firstly, it's really important to check the devices and the hardware that are connected to your MacBook, and here's how to do it. Firstly, shut down your MacBook. Unplug any devices that you have connected. Now, restart your MacBook and use it for a while to see whether the error goes away. If your MacBook fails to restart, try reconnecting each device one at a time each time you restart. Another way to fix your MacBook restarting problem is to use safe mode, as this will attempt to isolate the cause of the issue. All you have to do is disconnect all of your external devices, turn off your Mac and turn it back on again. Press and hold the D key and go through the on-screen instructions to diagnose any issues. Disabling startup apps on your Mac can also prevent it from restarting again and again. This will work if your device is overheating due to multiple apps running on startup. Firstly, go to the Apple menu, choose System Preferences, select Users and Groups, choose your username from the given menu, pick a startup item to disable, and press on the minus button. Now try restarting your MacBook and check whether the problem has been fixed. A few extra tips are to keep an eye on internal temperatures using your Mac fan control, make sure your machine has proper ventilation with no blockages, and clear all the dust, as it can be one of the main reasons behind your device overheating. If none of those solutions have fixed the issue, try updating your apps on your Mac device. It's very simple to do if you have a working Apple ID, and here's how to do it. Firstly, go to the App Store. Click on Updates from the sidebar. Hit the Update All button to update all your apps at once. And finally, clearing all corrupted settings and stored data in the NVRAM and PRAM can also fix the issue. Here's how to do it. Firstly, turn off your Mac. Press and hold the Option, Command, P and R keys for at least 20 seconds before releasing the keys, and just like that, you're done. If you've tried all these steps and nothing has worked, it's best to reset your MacBook completely and recover your important data. Want to share Recoverit is a robust data recovery tool for multi-platform users, and it can recover data from more than 2,000 storage devices, so you don't have to worry about your data being lost. Here's how it works. Firstly, download and install Want to Share Recoverit on your Mac computer. Open Recoverit and select the device where you've lost your data. Start the scan to find lost files that you can recover. All the recoverable files will be displayed on the results page. Lastly, all that's left to do is verify the files that you require and click on the recover button to retrieve the files that you need. And that brings us to the end of today's video and hopefully to the end of your MacBook restarting issues. All the solutions shared in this video aim to restore the normal functionality of your device and fix the errors associated with your system. If this video helped you, please share it with your fellow MacBook owners and feel free to leave any comments or suggestions down below. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Premium.